Hello and welcome. My name is Meepolis, she, they, and this is Literally Graphic. And today we are looking at the graphic memoir Dancing After 10 by Vivian Chong and Georgia Weber with support from Kathleen Ray. This edition was published in 2020 by Fantagraphics Books. The Goodreads description is as follows. Quote, in late 2004, Vivian Chong's life was changed forever when a rare skin disease, 10, toxic epidermal necrosis, left her with scar tissue up that would eventually blind her. As she was losing her sight, she put down as many drawings on paper as she could to document the experience. In Dancing After 10, Chong teams up with cartoonist Georgia Weber, whose graphic autobiography, Dumb, chronicles her own disability, to trace her journey out of darkness and into the spotlight. Chong now expresses her art through singing, stand-up, drumming, running, and dancing. The graphic novel is an inspirational tale and a powerful work of graphic medicine. End quote. This is certainly a book I've wanted to pick up for some time, but sticking to the constraints of my schedule, one of the ways I'm coping with the pandemic, it's been a minute. What kinds of keywords came to mind while reading this book? Toxic people, Toronto, memoir, accessibility, hospitals, travel, relationships, music, adaption, self-expression, and comedy. The text aspect of the book was good. I particularly liked the low-key diversity of speech bubbles. I wasn't really ever left guessing if something was said or thought, etc., and maybe I could find some pattern if I reread with just this aspect in mind, but there are shifts where we sometimes have dashed lines, sometimes have solid, mostly black text with some text in blue, white backgrounds on most bubbles, but sometimes a splash of the blue, pointy angle brackets are used to denote not English dialogue. I really liked how Vivian used expressive strings of cursive L's to denote general chatter that was proverbially not in focus. The artwork, arguably one of the selling points of the book, was also excellent. Was some of it harder to parse than others? Sure. The parts by Georgia and the parts by Vivian did look different, but they both served important purposes in telling the story of Vivian's life and felt very expressive. The collaboration process was also pretty interesting to read about and seemed like it could prove useful to setting a precedent for accessibility, which would be cool. This particular iteration of a very strict color palette was used beautifully. I really liked the shade of blue. Moving into the representation side of things, this book obviously exceeds my generally very low expectations of disability representation, with the general line being people are either fully able-bodied, or in the case of superheroes, super able-bodied, or dead. Vivian telling her own story brings much more nuance to the experience of disability, with the obvious caveat that disability is not a monolith, and this story is just Vivian's, which is definitely something I appreciate seeing whenever a woman expresses themselves, so I obviously think the gender representation was good too. The cast of supporting characters in Vivian's life each stood out with their own distinct qualities, although some of them were extremely self-absorbed, to say the least. Vivian's past relationships with men were covered in the book, but I wouldn't say that sexuality really played a huge role in the book. To conclude, I might have overreacted because this felt like a bit of an oasis in the middle of a desert. Somewhat self-imposed desert, to be honest, although certainly helped by general publishing trends, but I will be rating this book 5 out of 5 stars. If you can't get your hands on this book right away, I would also recommend the interview that Van Kaff did last year with both Vivian and Georgia. Link to the YouTube video in the description. Bye y'all, keep reading and resist white supremacy. And as always, Literally Graphic is created on land that should be given back to the traditional landholders, which in this case is, to my knowledge, the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation, Anishinaabe people, the Haudenosaunee Confederacy, and the Huron-Wendat Nation.